Hello, Aquarius. How's it going? Welcome to your October monthly reading, where I'm going to be looking at what's happening for you in this month of October. And today we are in the very beginning. We are in the first week of October. Today is October the 6th. So we have the entire month to go to check in on. Now you might notice, Jesus Murphy, what do you guys have? Stuck energy this month? Jeez. Anyways, you guys might notice that I have some new equipment here. And this new equipment is allowing for you to see the shuffling process and allowing for you to look at my hands overhead. Because you wouldn't believe it. Well, you probably would. But my children ended up replacing, or missing rather, my tarot deck. And immediately I went onto Amazon to try and find a new camera holder. The camera set. I'm entering into your guys' reading with brain fog. I swear, it's weird. And one day later, I needed to go get a new camera equipment set. So I did. And then the day after that, I found the one that my children misplaced. And it's like, holy moly. Here now I have two pieces of equipment. But I chose to use this one for this month's reading so that I could test it out. And I really like it so far. And it's the same old readings as usual, right? We've got our top row here that's going to be the events of something that you're dealing with. One event for each week of the month of October. And the bottom row is going to be the reasons for a certain event to be happening. Now, it's 1 in the afternoon. It's actually kind of typical for me to have brain fog around 1 in the afternoon. But, I mean, I know cards enough that I don't require much of that part of my brain to do a reading. It's all my intuition here when I do these readings. So we'll get through it, and then I'm going to go have a nap. what do they call it? A siesta. A midday siesta for me, because, yeah, I feel a little bit foggy. Now, this is going to be the first of the month of October from the 7th or 8th or so. So this is just coming up in a few days. And when I need to, I will also zoom into each of the cards so that you don't just have an overhead view of it. So Aquarians, let's get into it. We are starting off the beginning of the month of October for you in this first week with the World card. The World card is a cycle of completion. That's amazing. You see this wreath of victory that's around her here? That means that right now you are in a completion cycle to move on to the next. Sometimes, though, that gets a little bit, frustrating when you go through a new cycle, because at the beginning of a new cycle, it's great that you've completed the old one, but at the beginning of a new one, there can be some frustrations that come up. And of course, each one of you Aquarians are going to be dealing with this in a different area of life. Maybe some of you have completed something on the home front, the financial front, the emotional front, your relationships, what have you. But whatever it is, the reason for the completion is because you are starting to go through an ace, the Ace of Cups, a brand new cycle in the world of emotions. To get to the point where you feel like you are overflowing with emotions. Happy, satisfied in what area or direction you're going. It's like you know that you're doing the right thing at this point, which I really like for you. And since, again, this first week is from the 1st of October until the 7th or so, you're going to be in that energy where you know you're on the right path right now, cleansing yourself of negative energies, or maybe like me, physically cleansing yourself. I'm doing a parasite cleanse right now. Or just, you know, taking bad habits or bad people from your life and going forward. So the second quarter of the month, we're going to be going into this quarter here. This is going to be the 7th or 8th up until the 15th or so of the month. And what we have is the Wheel of Fortune in the reversal. The Wheel of Fortune in the reversal, it can sometimes mean that you are going into a less fortunate energy. I know a lot of people are, because this particular area is bordering on when we have, you know, the eclipses are about to happen. We've got Saturn going direct right around the same times, like the 22nd or 23rd of the month of October. This is the 15th, so this is right beforehand. And so instead of it just being like an unfortunate situation, I mean, some of you Aquarians might feel that it's almost like there's something brewing that might be a little frustrating. It could be for the other Aquarians out there that time feels like it's kind of slowing down. It's a little bit harder for you to achieve your goals because the Magician is here. He's in the reversal also, and the Magician is the manifester. Now, why is it? What is the reason for the Wheel of Fortune here to be going in the reversal direction? Because the Four of Pentacles. And the Four of Pentacles is the person who tries to really, really save his money, penny pinch his money, get his house in order even. But because it's the idea of you not being able to really get to your goals as appropriately or as quickly as you would want, then it insinuates that the Four of Pentacles is here because you are either saving money in the wrong way or approaching your job or your household in the wrong way. Or you might just be at a lack. It might be that you don't have enough money to do something. Not just saving it, but you might not have enough money at all, and that's kind of weighing on you. And I mean, hey, when we don't have resources, it could even be that. If you don't have the resources to do something, then it makes it that much more difficult to achieve whatever goals you want. Now, that's in the realm of pentacles with money, but imagine for resources for relationships. If you don't have the skills to communicate, or if the person you're dealing with doesn't have the resources or skills to communicate, then progress doesn't get made. If you don't have the skills to meet someone and like get out of your home, go to travel to different areas, you know, I joke a lot of the times that my mom used to tell me that I should meet a man in the rich financial district in Toronto, and it would have taken me to have money to get there, you know, to travel to that kind of a location. And so it takes resources to be able to accomplish things. And I think in the second quarter here in the month, you're analyzing the resources that you need and the resources that you don't have so that you can make plans for the future and get yourself to where you want to be. You can look at the house that you're living in and be like, I just don't have the right house. So what do I do to change it? Or I just don't have the right job. So what do I do to change it? It's that kind of energy of analyzing what your resources are. In the third quarter of the month, this is going to be after the 15th or so up to the 21st. And the King of Pentacles is here in the reversal. Now, the King can, of course, be a person because it is a court card, and court card just means it's a person card of the court, the high court, the kings, the queens, and things like that. And if that's the case, then it could be somebody who might be pentacles or earth energy, like, you know, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo kind of thing. And when they're in the reversal, it could be somebody who's kind of ungrounded. It doesn't have to be masculine. It could be, you know, feminine energy. Oh, I can't actually have this, honey. I'm fasting right now. Yeah, can you put these back in the fridge and then just clean off that plate? Yeah, go ahead. You can absolutely eat it. Sorry. Thank you, though, for doing something so nice. They are my favorite. I love leeks. Oh. Anyways, it could be a feminine energy, but this person could be taking on more masculine qualities of the earth sign here. And when this is in the reversal, it means that they're not grounded in reality very well. So, again, this could be a person that you're dealing with, but it could also be your kind of energy. It could be that in the third quarter of the month, you're not feeling very grounded. You're just not thinking about things realistically. And there is a higher case for that to be the situation here because the Page of Swords is here. That is also a court card, but it means underdeveloped thoughts. It's about trying to develop your thoughts, though. This is a card about realizing that you have to take ownership. You have to hold that sword and take ownership of your own thoughts. Because what is the Page? It is the card of a child. And the child is, you know, the energy of somebody who, if they were holding a sword, which again, the swords mean your thoughts, but if they were holding a sword, they would literally fling it all over the place. They would not be mastered. The child is not mastered in how to use the swords. And so this is a card that means, you know, underdeveloped, needing to mature in the suit of swords, in the suit of your thoughts. And so the reason why somebody is ungrounded is because somebody needs to develop their thinking in a more constructive way. They need to become more realistic. This very well could be your energy. We are transitioning interesting energies with Saturn, Aquarius, and all that kind of jazz. Saturn, Capricorn, right? Capricorn, Aquarius, both of these cards coming up here with those kind of energies. And so I feel like, oh goodness, I feel like you might be as scattered in that third quarter as my son is running around behind me. So yeah, the third quarter of the month seems to be a little bit of that scatterbrained energy, which I mean, it happens to the best of us. No judgment here on that. And then it leads you from all of the thinking of the outside world, the thinking that you've been doing. And in the fourth quarter of the month, this is going to be after the 21st or so, then we have you all of a sudden going within. The High Priestess card is here. And the High Priestess card is when, well, you act a little bit like the High Priestess. You act like the person who could be the priest, the spiritualist, the, you know, the tarot reader, in essence. And she's looking through the window. So it's almost like you've gotten to a point where you can kind of see what it is that you need to do. And what's the reason? The reason card of why you feel like an answer is coming to you by looking into the spiritual world is because the Tower moment happened for you at some point. The reason cards are usually about a past, because in order to become a reason for something, it must have already happened to give you that reason. So here we have the Tower as the reason for your spiritual experience. Now this Tower moment, again, is a quick change that has happened. It's usually something that's fairly devastating, and it probably happened to you already as the catalyst to get you to being spiritual. This is the kind of thing that happens when relationships break up. It's the kind of thing that happens when all of a sudden you might be out of money or out of a job. The universe essentially forces you to act by taking something and ripping it right out from under you. That's why it's a depiction of a burning building, a building burning down. But again, it's in the past, so I suspect that you already had this moment in order for you to get to this completion card of the world, the final card in the tarot deck, being merged with an ace, a number one, both of these meaning a new cycle. And so this month, you really are starting that new cycle, which again can feel uncomfortable, but it's so important. And I urge you to continue on with this journey of becoming the most grounded and realistic self that you can, because you're an air sign. You need to have like ownership and control of what your thoughts are, how you have gotten yourself into situations that are both good and bad. And then, you know, do your best to go forward and make sure that whatever decisions you make in the future can get you the goals and desires that you want to have. We don't want you to be making decisions that keep you in old cycles, especially since you've just completed a massive cycle for yourself. So with that being said, I'm going to leave you off with this. I'm going to, of course, do a reading for the next month of November as we get closer to that month. And if you want, you can have free readings that are done on TikTok on every Tuesday and Saturday, where I do free readings for people. So I wish you the best of luck on that, you guys. I will talk to you guys later. If you want a private reading, feel free to check out my Etsy shop. But that's everything. Blessings to you guys. You guys are awesome. I love you. Bye now.
Click and subscribe for more card readings.